I like living in Cardiff. You like living in Cardiff, do you?
Yeah.
Love it.
I lived here since 1982. It's good quality life here.
I couldn't consider living anywhere else.
The best shopping area's got castles, parks, walks, lakes.
I live in a place called Romney. I thoroughly enjoy it.
Because it's nice and peaceful and friendly people here.
We are close with each other, every communities.
And I find it's more calmer.
I've been all the time in London, but oh my God.
Mainly keeping moving because of with Parkinson's, you have to keep exercising. You have to keep moving and freeing up your joints. Otherwise you stiffen up.
See a scenery outside, yes. And really, I like Bridgend anyway.
Yeah, the parks.
Yeah, I like Bridgend. Yeah. Beacon Beacon. That's beautiful. Beacon, there's, yeah.
I go to it each week to a day centre, and I do most majority of things as regarding taking interest in things.
We celebrate, you know, every festival.
Yeah, every festival.
With one centre. So we love doing that, you know.
Cinema. We like to go to the pub, don't we, and have a pint.
Life is going a bit hard, you know, because the roads are going narrow. Traffic is going stuck, you know. We are living in the city centre and it's difficult day by day. One-way traffic and this and that, you know, business is going ruin and this and that, you know.
One thing, swimming pool, we have to book that place, then I can go. Before COVID, I go just like that when I want to go, but now that's stopped me.
Buses, because I live by Heath, and the hospital buses are not on time. I know they used to come every 10 minutes, then they used to come every half hour. Now every hour, after 4 o'clock, you don't get bus to Lando. And some people got relatives them. Some people got appointments, they missed appointments. Even the Heath Hospital appointments, some people miss it because the buses are not reliable at all.
My mobility is limited. I have to rely on my wife to drive me, and then she's got places she wants to go as well. So it was very sad when I sold my car. It was like having a leg cut off. I've had a car since I was 16, and to lose that mobility and freedom of movement, it was a bit of a blow to me.
Money is a massive stumbling block, but like I said, that's the same for everybody at the moment. And I've obviously had to give up work and trying to survive on carers, universal credit, whatever it is. It's hard, but it's doable. But there's no extras for going out like we used to when we were both working, obviously.
We like, you know, face-to-face things, you know. But these days, it's very difficult. Life is.
The main thing that helps me is the work that I do for Parkinson's Association. It's our duty, our job, to find ways of helping people with Parkinson's to help themselves. And that it's really important that they really help themselves.
Everything is online. We are still old generation, you know. It's okay for the new generation, but not for us, you know.
I don't think about it. Just take it as it comes. There's nothing much we can do about it anyway. To be honest, if they can improve the health problems, because hospitals, my goodness.
So I don't know why the life is going not easy, more difficult.
No, I wouldn't want anything to be sort of happen to any of my family. You know, that's the last thing I'd want, you know.
Everything going up, you know, the energy, the bills,
the food,
yes.
It gets harder as you go along, and the stress of it, I think, more than anything.
I still worry greatly about the future, and everybody with Parkinson's does, because we know we're heading downhill. We know that the statistics show that about 40% of people with Parkinson's get dementia. It's not Alzheimer's dementia, it's more a memory loss dementia. And I would not like to go down that path. I'd like to keep my memories.
In an evening, I don't put my light on. I'm sitting down in the dark, until about 8-9 o'clock. I turn the little bit times turning on light, then I go to bed because I'm worried about the bills coming, big bills in the winter time.
What shall we look forward to? You tell me. Everything is going everywhere, so I don't know. Just take it as it comes, nothing else.
Well, I hope the future is regarding myself and my family. My family comes first and foremost. You know, I've got to say I've got a grandson, got a granddaughter.
I suppose that is out there, but it's knowing how to get that support. There's not much information about how you go about getting the support. Well, we were assessed quite a few months ago. Some social worker came from Birmingham. I haven't heard nothing since. We were entitled to some help because we didn't have enough money to pay for it, basically, and that's the last I heard. I haven't heard anything since. I don't even know who to get in touch with.
No, nowhere. Either you go to council, you go to National Health, you go anywhere. No support at all, no.
And as I said, you know, you can get assistance from a lot of people who, you know, if you've got a problem, they can relate to the problem and assist you if there's a, if there's anything complicated or anything like that, they can pick up on it. And as I said, then it goes on the forward level, you know.
There's never enough support for people with Parkinson's. We always ask for more, but it has improved greatly over the last few years.
I don't think there's enough support for most conditions that we have, but I think the Alzheimer's is in my family and they've been poorly, poorly let down.
The friendly people, I think. Yeah, we heard, you know, every cities they have got so many problems, you know, but we are safe.
The family's here, isn't it? So that's all well, it's a plus and a minus on times. Well, we've got access to most things, haven't we, really? We've got all the main shops. There's, you know, a choice of cinemas.
And you get for the around for your everything. Like a Muslim people find for their easily to halal foods.
I'm so happy woman connect, help poor people to bring up, to learn English, anything, yoga, English, cycling, go in a trip, one day trip.
Yeah. It's good life here.
Yeah, I like Welsh people. Yeah. I got my neighbor, she calls me her daughter, so I know.